Two LA County Sheriff's deputies caught on camera throwing a woman to the ground during an arrest have now been taken off of field patrol duties.
This as the department launches an investigation into their use of force. KTLA-5's Carlos Herrera live outside the LASD headquarters in downtown LA with the latest details. Carlos, good morning.
Hey, good morning, I'm Chris and Megan. And at the order of LA County Sheriff Robert Luna, both unidentified deputies have already been removed from street patrol, as you already mentioned. But after that hard-to-watch incident, demonstrators, protesters, especially in the Lancaster area, say those two deputies deserve a way harsher punishment.
No justice! No justice!
Yesterday, dozens of demonstrators marched at the Lancaster Winco grocery store protesting that LA County deputies routinely mishandle minorities and that the two deputies involved in that controversial incident need to be fired. The anger stems from this June 24th confrontation, which was recorded on body-worn cameras. It shows the deputies' use of force in the store's parking lot. A man and woman believed to be related were suspected of stealing and fighting with store employees. Those workers eventually called 911. Responding deputies found the couple in the parking lot and placed the man in handcuffs as the woman stands a few feet away, filming the encounter on her cell phone. A deputy then moves on to her, throws her to the ground as she yells that she did nothing. At one point during the struggle, the deputy pepper sprays her and finally places her in a patrol unit. Community activists say it's a perfect example of violent policing against African Americans.
The video that is being filmed from the car, I was on my knees in the passenger seat and I just couldn't believe my eyes. I was just so upset.
LA County Sheriff Robert Luna says he didn't learn about the encounter until 6 days after it happened. He's calling it disturbing and says an investigation into the use of force is already underway.
I want to make it clear to all of our community that this investigation is to objectively, and I do repeat objectively, determine if the force used was reasonable, if it was necessary, if it was appropriate and proportional to the level of actions that were described.
And both suspects have already been charged with attempted petty theft and battery on those store employees. In the meantime, LA County Sheriff Robert Luna already planning a community meeting in Lancaster next week. An exact day and time have not been announced. Chris and Megan.
First of all praises to the Father, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Ruach Adash. Shabbat Shalom to all the brothers and sisters in recognition to observing this day for worshiping the Most High. Sundown this evening to sundown tomorrow evening. People, let's get some rest, worship, and praises in to the Most High. He is definitely worthy of such. We need to show Him that we love Him because He loves us, you understand? But the thing is, with us, we're not showing enough appreciation to Him for how He's delivering those of us in these dark days, you understand? Now, the video that I showed you has really nothing to do with today's edification. I just wanted to reiterate that particular situation that took place in LA with the sheriff, deputy, you know, violating, you know, that brother and sister at that store. You understand? As you can see that a lot of the people were there at the store protesting, talking about no justice and no peace. As usual, you know, we always get, you know, these particular situations happening. We're no shortage of them. As a matter of fact, I am tired of seeing them. I really am tired of looking at it. It's time to drive the nail into the coffin, you know, as to what we need to start doing as a people. You understand? So before we get into the day's edification, I just wanted to reiterate what we need to understand. You understand? Because, well, let the Most High tell you. Let's go over here in John. We're going to start here in John on this particular subject. I'm not going to spend too much time on it. We're going to do John and 2 Chronicles 7 and 14. I just want to show you guys what it is. Okay, this is the Hamashiach himself, Yahweh Shai Hamashiach. This is him speaking. I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Okay. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Listen to this. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can ye, except ye abide in me. You understand that? This is the Hamashiach himself is telling his people this. Verse 5. I am the vine, ye are the branches. That's us. He's the vine, we are the branches. Listen, he that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth much fruit. For without me, ye can do nothing. Do you understand that? Do you see my point? We need to abide in Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. Because with all of these years that we've been under the curses, we really haven't done nothing. You know, we have civil rights and all that, and it has been hijacked, and they're working like hell to take away, you know, all the things that were accomplished and achieved for our civil rights went far as our people. The Most High gave us that little bit right there. You understand? We had, like I said yesterday in the video I did on that particular situation, we had the Panthers, we had Martin Luther King, we had Malcolm X, you know, and a host of other, Medgar Evers, a host of other civil rights leaders. And yet here to this day, we've came a little way, but the Most High allowed that. But we are not where we should be. We're still being oppressed by animals wearing badges, okay? And that's basically what it boils down to. Not only the animals that wear badges, but even animals that dwell among us in our own communities. You understand what I'm saying? That get arrested by the animals with badges, but then tap them on the wrist to turn them loose all over again back in our own communities to do the same kind of tyranny that animals with badges do to their own people. Okay? It's time that we understand who's our bread and butter? You understand what I'm saying? It's time we understand that. We ain't going to achieve nothing. We ain't going to do nothing of ourselves. He already said it. And if he said it, that's just what it is. No getting away from that. Let's go over in 2 Chronicles. This is Yahweh, the Father, talking. Listen to this. 2 Chronicles 7, 14. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sin and heal and will heal their land. Okay? Look, when he says he will heal our land, he means not only the land that we dwell in, although we're not back there yet, but I'm just saying, when he says that, he also means healing us, because our bodies was made from the land itself. That means healing our bodies, even making us glorified and everything else, glorified into spiritual bodies. I'm just saying, that's healing in itself. But first of all, we need to humble ourselves and seek him and pray. Seek his face. We're not doing this enough. We're not. And that's just what it is. And until we do, these things are going to continue to plague us to this day. Until we get the message. So all of this, no justice, no peace, and all that mess, ain't going to do nothing. It ain't going to do nothing. Our eye is not on the prize. Our eye need to be on the prize, and the prize is Yahawashi HaMashiach, who the Father gave us for salvation. That's just what it is. Now, enough said on that. Enough said on that. I just wanted to tap on that a little bit. Okay? We're going to talk about today the judgment of the great whore. You understand that? That rise the dragon. It's terrible, awful, dreadful beast. You understand that? This is what we're going to talk about today. And what's going to happen to this great whore, as well as this dragon. You understand what I'm saying? Now, so let's go over here. And let's see. Revelation 17. We taking this on down to verse 18. Okay. So, Revelation 17, verse 1, and it reads, "And there came one of the seven angels which had the seven vials and talked with me, saying unto me, Come hither. I will show unto thee the judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters." Okay. "With whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth have been made drunk with the wine of her fornication." Have we not been made drunk with the wine of this great whore's fornication? Course we have. We've been tricked, bamboozled, and everything else through television, number one, rap music. You understand? We think it's okay to sin. All of this, these things that blasphemous things that rap speaks, you know, and it gets into the minds of our youth, and they think it's okay to sell drugs, kill, you know, his brother and his sister. You understand? Like I said, first of all, the movies is full of this kind of stuff. We have been made drunk with all these lies. Okay? To continue, verse 3. "So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness, and I saw a woman sit up on a scarlet colored beast, full of names of blasphemy, having seven heads and 10 horns." Looks a lot like what I just showed you, didn't it? That's what it's describing here. "And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand full of abominations and filthiness of her fornication." America, aka spiritual Babylon. Okay? "And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery Babylon, the great, the mother of harlots, and abominations of the earth." Okay? We have abominations of the earth walking around us day in and day out. We work around them. We look at them as good friends. You know, we eat at restaurants around them and all of those things. But yet, they think and they look at us as the abominations. You understand what I'm saying? But no. Let's continue. "And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Yahawashi. And when I saw her, I wondered with great admiration. And the angel said unto me, Wherefore didst thou marvel?" Question. "I will tell thee the mystery of the woman and of the beast that carrieth her, which have the seven heads and 10 horns." Okay? Now, those seven hit one. Well, let the angel tell him. Let the angel tell us. The beast that thou sawest was and is not, and shall ascend out of the bottomless pit and go into perdition. Perdition means to be destroyed, to die. Okay? Let's continue. And they that dwell on the earth shall wonder whose name were not written in the book of life from the foundation of the world, when they behold the beast that was and is not and yet is. Okay? And here is the mind which hath wisdom. The seven heads are seven mountains on which the woman sitteth. And there are seven kings. Five are fallen, and one is, and the other is not yet come. And when he cometh, he must continue a short space. Okay? When he cometh, and that is the Antichrist. You understand? See, these beasts that you're talking about are actually nations. Okay? But this woman is sitting on top of those nations. The great whore herself, she ride those nations. She's controlling those other nations. And they are all the nations that are against Yahawashai's people. You understand that? Let's continue. And the beast that was and is not, even he is the eighth and is of the seven and goeth into perdition, again will die. This beast will. This system is going to be taken down. Okay? Along with the rest of those mountains. They going down. Remember what I said those mountains were. Those are the nations. Verse 12. And the 10 horns which thou sawest are 10 kings, which have received no kingdom as yet, but receive power as kings 1 hour with the beast. See, the thing is this. What we got to understand about the devil. Just like we like to give our children good things and gifts and stuff like that. Well, when the earth was given into the hand of that wicked one, the devil himself, then he came and he gave his children, he set them up to run it. And he gave them great things. So this is what this is all revolving around. Verse 13. These have one mind and shall give their power and strength unto the beast. Okay? These shall make war with the lamb, and the lamb shall overcome them. That's Yahawashi. For he is Lord of lords and King of kings. And they that are with him are called and chosen and faithful. Are we not with him? Do you want to be called, chosen, and faithful? I do. And I hope you do too. This stuff is important. This is not a fairy tale. This is based on our eternal salvation. This is no joke, people. It's time we take these things serious. Be just like the enemy. You understand? The enemy is of one mind, and that's to conquer and destroy the saints of this earth and overcome the Hamashiach, as well as the Ancient of Days was the Father himself. You understand that? This is what we have to be like. One mind, the opposite of what this negative is all about. You understand what I'm saying? Let's continue. And he said unto me, the waters which thou sawest, where the whore sitteth, are people and multitudes and nations and tongues. Okay? And the 10 horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the whore and shall make her desolate and naked and shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire. Why? Because the nations hate Mystery Babylon, AKA America. The dollar is already collapsing. I think, who is it? China, France, them places like that. I'm not sure, but there are some different countries that's giving up the dollar. You understand? And to this day, now, you know, America does not have the power over the nations like they used to. Things are changing. Now, just because these nations is going to turn on this great whore, doesn't mean that they are not going down with that great whore, okay? Because they are. Let's continue. Verse 17, for Yahweh hath put in their hearts to fulfill his will and to agree and give their kingdom unto the beast until the words of Yahweh shall be fulfilled, okay? And the woman which thou sawest is that great city which reigneth over the kings of the earth. Okay? Yeah, she reigns over the kings of the earth. She's in control now, but she's going down. She's going down. Okay? This is what we got to understand. This is not going to last much longer. I'm telling you, we see all kinds of things is coming up on the earth. You understand? It's going just like the Father said it would be going. Prophecy fulfilling itself day in and day out. We don't have time to play anymore. Playtime's over. Playtime is over, people. This is no joke. Time to wake up. Time to become as of one mind in focus to Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai. You understand that? That's the only way we are going to overcome. Don't you want to rule in the kingdom over your oppressor and your enemy? You know about the scripture when it says, those that lead into captivity shall go into captivity. Those who kill with the sword must be killed by the sword. You understand that? Well, that's what the kingdom is going to be about. We will rule over this remnant, the remnant of us, the hopeful remnant, I'm going to just say that. We'll rule over these devils. Okay? And that's just what it is. That's all I got on this, my people. I hope I said something to stimulate spiritual growth. And I hope this lesson was edifying to you. You understand? Like, comment, share, and subscribe. People, please remember to live your life as though we're being watched. Simply because we are. This is James, and I'm out. Peace.